Very good morning to all the students of class plus one B beta. So today is the last day before vacation and only one topic is left because you will be having your exams after vacation, immediately after that. Fine. So only one topic is left. We will be covering this topic today only, speech writing. This writing skill you have been doing since class fifth and sixth. Fine. The only difference is that difficulty level of the speech writing increases. Fine. So before, beta, firstly, you, every one of you, kindly note down all the value points. I would be seeing the notebooks also in between. Don't just think that we need not write. We'll do it later. Later on, you never know that in that much detail we'll be doing or not. Fine. So kindly note down the details, all the details of the speech writing, all the value points, and then we will do examples. I will be sharing the screen with you all then. Fine. So first of all, beta, start with a quotation. The very first point is start with a quotation. It can be a quote or saying by any famous personality. Fine, like Mahatma Gandhi said, or you can say about any other person, or suppose if you do not remember the words of any other person, you can write a common quote only, anything. Honesty is the best legacy, discipline, fine, environment. What are the common topics which are usually there for, you can say, speech writing based on education, equal opportunities, gender discrimination? So I would be discussing the topics also. Before that, let me just tell you that what to be included in the first paragraph. As you can see, I have bracketed the whole information, that this much information should be there in the first paragraph. Fine, it is clear. Start with a quotation. Fine. And after that, you will greet the audience. Now, what do you mean by greet the audience? You will wish the audience. Fine. Like you say that a very warm morning, you can say a very warm welcome to all my, you can say pleasant morning. There are various ways of greeting the audience. Very good morning to one and all. One and all means each and every person present over there. A very good morning to the cheerful audience. Fine. Any other way you can use to wish the audience. Fine. But wish should be mentioned. And suppose if it is mentioned that it's a competition, you're going to participate, then you can also mention that a very good morning to all the, you can say, members of the jury, respected principal, judges. You can say, you can just bifurcate the audience. Fine. And all my fellow friends. And all my fellow competitors in that way. Clear? After greeting the audience, you will introduce yourself. Fine? You will give your introduction that I am, fine, in that way. I am Dia of class plus 1B standing in front of you to express my opinion on the topic, fine, dash, on the occasion of dash. So you need to mention the topic as well as the occasion. Clear? If no occasion is mentioned in the statement, fine. Suppose there is World Environment Day and you are supposed to give a speech, then you can say that I am Anjali of class plus 1B standing in front of you to express my opinion or to voice my opinion. There are different ways of putting forth your viewpoint. Okay, beta. To voice my opinion on the burning issue. Burning issue is the means the these days, which is current and everybody is talking about it. Fine. That water conservation, environment conservation, fine, in that way, on the occasion of World Environment Day, in that way. So first para should include all these points. Is it clear to everyone? Start with a quotation, greet the audience, and the logical order should be this only. You cannot introduce the topic in the very first line and then you will be giving your introduction. Fine. But yes, you can give your introduction and then give a quotation, that you can do. But this is the right way. Firstly, start with a quotation, greet the audience, then introduce yourself and then introduce the topic and the occasion. This much information should be there in first paragraph. Okay. Then we have a second and third paragraph. in second and third paragraph. Now, most of the times you will be getting a topic in which some problem is mentioned. Fine. And you're supposed to give solution to that also, obviously. Find what is the reason behind many, you can say, increasing population. Suppose we take one topic. Then you'll discuss about the causes of increase in population, effects of increasing population, various features. Solutions must be there. If you discuss the problem, you have to give suggestions also. That should be in second paragraph. You will discuss causes, effects. And in third paragraph, you will be giving solutions to the problem. Okay. And now the points which should be considered while writing your content of the speech, use personal pronoun I. Fine. Now, what is a speech? When you stand, you're standing on a dais and you're addressing the people. Fine. As the way students are doing in the morning assembly, fine. They're standing and giving speeches every day in that way. So, it's like one's opinion only, your personal opinion. So you will be using personal pronoun I, that I would like to say that, and don't try to, you know, be innovative while putting forth your ideas, rather than saying, I want to say that, I want to say that, I want to say that. That sounds very boring and dull. Fine. Try to use innovative ways of expressing your opinion. I would like to say that. Fine. In that way. I want to convey to my audience. Let me tell you, friends. Fine. Different ways I'm using. You can note down also. Let me tell you, my dear friends, and keep on addressing the audience. This way, audience will be connected to you. Fine. Twice or thrice, you can say address the audience in between. That, my dear audience, my dear friends, my dear fellows, in that way. Fine. Keep on addressing them and then keep on telling the causes. Let me tell you the solutions to this, my dear friends, that first of all, we have to, suppose you're talking about environment. Fine. First of all, we have to start as an individual. We should start growing plants at our own homes. Fine. We should not... segregation of the, you can say, garbage waste. Fine. In that way, any point, content should be quality wise very good. Fine. As well as you keep on addressing the audience and keep on using the personal pronoun I. And now comes the very important device that is called rhetoric. Now, what is this rhetoric? By just reading the name, you might be thinking, what is a rhetoric? Rhetoric device here, I mean to say that it is a way when you pose a question to your audience. Fine. And you are giving answer to it on your own. That makes the speech more interesting, better. Fine. What you'll be doing, you'll be saying that, do you know that how many species are left on this earth? Let me tell you, my dear friends, that more than dash jo bhi aapka fact and data. Clear? So this is a way of capturing the attention of the audience. Clear? But it doesn't mean that I have mentioned use rhetoric device, that after every line you will be using rhetoric, that do you know, let me tell you, do you know, in that way, that will sound again very, you can say, boring. And repeated things should not be there. Fine? It should be at least... you can say you can use it once only. So this is the magic wand in your hand, which you will be just moving for one time only. Clear? Always remember. Clear? Rhetoric device should be used only once. But it should be there. It is part of speech. Now, again, important thing. What do you mean by this, Sahaj? Yes. Okay, fine. I'm coming to that point only, Sahaj. Just wait. If you can see, next point is, Sahaj is asking, can we use hypothetical data? Yes, hypothetical data you can use, because next point you can see, add facts and references from news. Let one student join. Japanpreet. Fine. So you should add facts and references from beta news or any magazine or any book or any, you can say, data given by any famous personality. Fine. You have heard, you have just seen a documentary at a channel. Fine. You are quoting any notable persona. Fine. So it should be there, any facts and reference from any news article or documentary or any famous personality. Fine. That will make your speech more reliable, that whatever you are speaking, audience will say, okay, this person, what will make you different from the other speaker? Suppose it's a competition in your school and you have participated in it. How can you capture the attention of the audience? You know, people just start feeling very bored. That, okay, what this person is speaking, very dull way. The way you speak, that is a different thing. This is a speech writing. You have to write a speech. So all these components must be present in your speech. Fine, facts and references and data, fine, must be there. You can invent also, but it should be logical enough. If you have the true knowledge, add it. That is well and good. If you do not have any true knowledge, you can add hypothetical data also, as SHPT is asked. Fine. So at last, beta, conclude your viewpoints. Now, I just prefer when you conclude your viewpoints in the last para. Fine. Total, how many paragraphs now? First is this, second and third, where you will be developing your content. This you can increase also. It's up to you. It can be in three paragraphs also. Suppose in one paragraph, you discuss the causes of the problem. In second, third paragraph, you discuss the effects of the problem. In fourth paragraph, you discuss the solutions to the problem. In the last paragraph, you are going to conclude your viewpoint. So minimum three paragraph, maximum 5 to 6 paragraph, fine, in a speech. Depending upon, suppose if you get a speech writing for 10 marks, then you are supposed to write at least 5 to 6 paragraphs. Fine. And if you are getting a speech for 6 marks only, then you can write in 3 paragraphs also. It depends upon the marking. Many students say, ma'am, I have written more and you have not given marks. It's not about writing more. It's about writing the quality content, and all the components must be there. Use very embellished vocabulary, rich vocabulary, as the class plus one student would write. Okay. So conclude your viewpoints. You can also conclude your viewpoints by giving a quotation again, by giving, you can say, adding some other famous persona's quotation, by putting in inverted commas and by winding up whatever you have said. Suggestions to all the, you can say, problems in 2 lines, 3 lines. Fine. And very dramatic way of ending the speech. You can ask the audience again, or you can end up your speech by giving a warning. Suppose if it is a very dangerous situation, given that water is just on the verge of extinction, and write a speech. Fine. Or trees are being cut by people, environment is being harmed at very faster pace. So you want to give warning to your audience. So you can end up by giving the warning that, my dear friends, if we do not wake up now, it will be too late for us to repent later. Fine. So it's a kind of warning to the audience. It can be an open-ended question. Fine. Responsibility lies upon us. Responsibility lies upon our shoulders now, whether we want to make our lives or whether we want to mar our lives. With this, I would take permission from you all. Fine. Then after that, thank the audience. That is very important. Directly, it carries 1 mark. If you will not thank your audience, 1 mark straight away will be deducted. Clear? So how will you say thank you? You can just write thank you on left side. Or you can say thanks for being the patient listeners. Patient here means the people who have patience. Okay. Not the ones who are in hospital. Right? So thanks for being the patient listeners. All the points I have covered up. If you have doubt, just send me message in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and speak also. If I need to discuss any of the points, tell me. Now I would be sharing the screen by showing you various samples of, you can say, CBSE sample papers, in which there are a lot of, everybody has noted down, beta. Send me thumbs up quickly. Okay, Diya, I will be explaining. Wait. Everybody has noted down all the points. What is the difference between causes and effects? Beta, see, causes. What are the causes of, you can say, many people are harming the environment? What are the causes behind it? What are the causes? Like, we people are, you can say, factories are being built in place of, you can say, forests. Forests are being cut. People are fulfilling their own personal needs. Fine. So there are many causes that people are harming the environment. In the modern buildings, there is no place for, there is place for parking the cars, but there is no place for having a small garden or kitchen garden. Many reasons are there of depletion of the environment, fine? And these are the causes only. And now effects, what are the effects? Lack of oxygen. What are the effects? Ailments are increasing, people are getting sick, fine? So these are the effects of that problem. That is the difference, okay, clear? Now, let me share the screen with you all, beta. All the points I have covered. So we would be doing now. Yes, speech writing class 11th. Yes, beta. These points to be kept in mind, firstly. A speech should begin with... Right? You can see the highlighted screen. Speech should begin with a catchy introduction in the form of anecdote, quotation, statistical data, or a thought-provoking question. Fine? So you can, the students who cannot, you know, always produce a quote in the beginning, they can also add up any anecdote. Anecdote is any, you can say, story in a, you can say, in few lines. It's not like you're writing a one-page story, or any incident, actually, a small incident. Suppose, and you can say statistical data. Suppose you're writing about the safety of girl child. Fine. You can start with the heading that, 5-year-old molested in Dwarka, Delhi. 2-year-old abandoned, fine, by the mother only. Fine, 3 headings you spoke from the newspaper you have given. Fine, you have added data and facts. Fine. Good morning to all my dear friends. Here I, Kritika of class plus one, stand in front of you all. Fine. In that way, you will be expressing. So you can start with the, rather than writing only quotation, you can start with any statistical data or thought-provoking question in the beginning. Make your beginning very impressive. Fine? A good beginning means half work done. Then after that, a speech must reflect the speaker's clarity of thought, accuracy of facts, and a balanced view through a comparison and contrast with other viewpoints. Clear? It should reflect clarity of thought. It should not be vague. Vague means unclear. Then after listening to or after reading your speech, it should be clear that, okay, speaker has the sound knowledge of this topic. His vision is clear. His viewpoint is clear. Speech may also give reference to newspaper reports, posters, advertisements, or the stimuli, fine? Restrict the main part of the speech to the word limit of 150 to 200 words. So this is the word limit, beta. Up to 200 words means up to 5-6 paragraphs. Clear all the points? format is clear, all the points are clear. Now let's start with the examples, Beta. I would be reading it aloud, or I would ask any one of you to speak. Anyone would like to read it? Divnoor? Divnoor, can you read it, Beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Beta, read it. Firstly, to enforce strict discipline in schools and colleges is a great problem nowadays. Write a speech in about 150 to 200 words to be delivered in the school morning assembly on the problem of discipline. You are Mohini or Mohit. Remember, name is given to you. You start reading the book.
Respected principal, sir, teachers, and dear friends, I am Mohini of Class Plus Mandi. It is rightly said by Swami Dayanand, discipline is necessary not only in schools and colleges, but in all walks of life. Absence of discipline will lead to chaos and confusion in life. Today, I will speak on the value of discipline in life. Discipline is the key to keep things in order. It is absolutely essential for the growth and development of an individual and a healthy society. It is indispensable for everyone in all spheres of life. That is at home, school, playground, society, in service, public life, and everywhere. Discipline must be inculcated early in life. If the child is allowed unchecked freedom, it becomes wayward. Student life is the seed time of life. Hence, the value of discipline in academic life cannot be underestimated. Proper counseling and guidance by parents and teachers can help the students to maintain discipline. Punishment, physical or financial, cannot be a corrective measure. Thank you.
Very good. You can mute yourself, Beta. See, firstly, I appreciate Divnoor Kaur, the way she read. It is just by giving proper pose, fine, and the words which needed stress, and she gave stress over there. The words means with proper intonation. When you are giving a speech on, you can say a dais, you are standing and speaking. Fine, there should be a voice modulation. Rising and falling of the voice. That is another way. We are doing speech writing, no doubt, but you should know how to speak. Fine, if you need to, you should know that where to rise the level of or the pitch of my voice and where to lower it down. When you pose a question, you can rise it. Can you tell me, friends, why this is happening with us? Let me tell you, my dear friends, this is the reason. Fine. So rise and fall should be there. Intonation should be there. That's a separate thing. We are preparing how to write a speech. Fine. So you can see introduction is there. Greeting is there. And she has added a quote after the introduction. That is also correct. Clear? Firstly, introduction, I am Mohini. And you cannot write your own name if no name is you can say if name is given to you, you are Mohini or Mohit. You will be using this name only. Fine. Whatever is written. Clear? You can see now marking scheme, content, four, format, half, then heading and for, you can say thanks to the audience, half. Total 8 marks they have given over here. So this is the way how they bifurcate the speech. We also see the content, vocabulary. Then you can see this thing better. Media has a strong hold on society. Write a speech in about 150 to 200 words on how media influences public opinion to be delivered in the school assembly. Fine. Now, who would be reading? Anjali, you can speak, Beta. Unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Beta, you can speak.
Respected principal, sir, honorable teachers, and my dear friends, I, Mehak Prasad of Class Plus 1C, will enlighten you today on the fact that media has a strong hold on society. It influences public opinion significantly because people consider true whatever the media depicts, whether it is an electronic media like TV and radio, social media like Facebook and Twitter, cyber media like the internet and email, or the print media like newspaper and magazines. However, in some cases, the actual situation is totally different from what is depicted in the media. Media dramatizes the information to serve its own ends and usually to gain popularity. Everybody, yes, everybody are exposed to different forms of media. People are not always able to celebrate the fact from opinion and
separate
fact from opinion and believe or disbelieve what they see, hear, or read. This molds your opinion and actions, thus enabling the media to have a strong hold on society. Over-reporting as well as under-reporting can lead to misinformed opinions. It is for journalistic community to take initiative and seek to address the various concerns regarding the profession. The public also should be discerning enough to separate facts from opinions and from one's viewpoint accordingly. Thank you.
Very good. You can mute yourself. So she has also read beautifully. Let me tell you, this speech is not a model speech for us. Why? Because they have not used first person pronoun. They have not used any jargons, any rhetoric device. Fine. So no doubt the data is well knitted in this. Examples and knowledge is reflected, but it is more like an article. Fine. So in this speech, what you need to do is you need to add firstly the personal pronoun, rhetoric device, fine, and different ways of connecting with the audience. That is missed in this speech. Clear? So sometimes even on the net, we do not find the best examples. Clear, beta? So now what sort of topics of speech writing? See, this is the peer pressure, beneficial or not. Peer pressure is, who's a peer? Peer group is the one who's, you can say, you're all your friends. They are the peer group of your age who are sitting with you, playing with you, studying with you all together, fine? So peer group is all the people whose opinion matters to you, fine? So peer pressure is beneficial as long as we know our limits. So clear, many topics, environment, health, education, equal opportunities related to some social issues, social media, girl child, you can say, or this now recently we have COVID, fine? How to just prevent it, how we can save ourselves from such scenario, from such kind of pandemics, racism, many topics are there, fine? Now, behavioral problems of teenagers, fine? Ideal Indian, ideal student, ideal human being, clear? Many topics are there. You have to prepare. Importance of mother tongue, importance of English language, 21st century skills, communication skills, healthy habits. It can be the simplest topic ever, or it can be the trickiest topic too. Clear? So we are not left with more than 2 minutes. So let me explain now. Speech writing is clear to everyone. If you have any doubt, do ask me, beta. All the points, let me show you once again. Fine, all the points are there. Start with the quotation, greet the audience, introduce yourself, introduce the topic and occasion. Clear in the first paragraph. Then development of the topic. In second, third and fourth paragraph also you can write. Fine, causes, effects, features, solutions to the problem. And in these paragraphs only, you will be adding facts. Fine, jargons, anecdotes, or data, or statistical data, whatever you. And you will be using first person pronoun, I. You will be using rhetoric in between anywhere. Fine, and add facts and references from news, etc. Then you will be concluding your viewpoints and you will be thanking the audience at last. So all the points are clear to you. Now only 5 students are left, those who have not sent me registration form. kindly send it by all means today only. Clear, beta? You have to send it by all means today only. And because you are going to have or you're going to enjoy your vacation, rather than wasting time, just killing your time on social media, you can make proper use of it also. Fine, you can upgrade your knowledge. I would be sharing one piece of writing with you all today. Fine, I'll be sending in WhatsApp group. You need to read that. Fine, you need to read that and follow it. How you can utilize your time properly. Fine. And I'm not going to give you much load of work or holidays homework because you're going to prepare for your exams, PT1 exams. And soon teachers will be sending you the syllabus for PT1, other subject teachers also. I have already, you can say, sent to you yesterday only, you could see. Clear? And if any doubt regarding the syllabus is there, you can ask the teacher at any time. Okay. And eat healthy, stay hydrated. Don't go out without any need. If it's the emergency only, then above all, respect your parents, love your parents, be with them. This is the time when you can spend time, okay? Otherwise, again, you will be busy into online classes, then you have tuitions and you are busy in your self-study, fine? So make most of this time, spend quality time with your family, follow any hobby, any skill you can learn, any new skill also, whatever you feel like, whatever your, you can say, passion is, hobby is, just relish it, relish this moment. Okay, happy holidays to all of you. With this, I'm just bidding goodbye to all of you. Okay, thank you, Vitor.